guys, it's Diane, and tonight we are going to talk about, I think what's going to be considered a pretty sensitive topic, but I think it's something that should be talked about and opened up and kind of brought out into the general population. And I'm going to share a little bit of my story with you and why I am so passionate about nutrition and women's bodies and hormones and really empowering other women to take control of their own health by using common sense in line with some advice that you might be getting from your doctor. So if you are new to me, my name is Diane and I have been helping women for the past 25 years find nutrition plans and fitness programs to help them look and feel their best and live their most authentic life. For me recently, that has been done through intermittent fasting, but I have a long history of using nutrition and lifestyle changes to help me gain control and sort of fix my body. And just by treating my body sort of like an experiment project and researching some things and implementing things and having some things not work and then having some things work really great for me and my family. And so my journey with kind of being fascinated with my hormones started really early on when I was in high school, and I think my fascination with nutrition kind of started then too. And for some reason, food and my body sort of just made sense, and the ability to kind of manipulate my body and change the way I looked and change my physique and just experiment with nutrition has always been something that I've been able to do very easily, and it's always made common sense to me. And so it's just been sort of this natural progression through my life to incorporate nutrition and to share nutrition with other women so that they can hopefully find some happiness with their bodies and with some things that they might be going through difficulty-wise with their body. So in the past, I don't know, probably 10 years or so, things really got serious with me in nutrition when I was 38. And we were pregnant with our second pregnancy, and 4 months into the pregnancy, I suddenly had a miscarriage. No miscarriage is easy. I understand that. And it's amazing when you go through one of those situations, how many women kind of reach out to kind of help you through that situation, and you had no idea they had gone through the same thing. I think which is another reason why I'm very open about some of the struggles that I have, because when I was going through that really dark time when we had that miscarriage, I had so many women rally around me and kind of share their experiences with me. And it really, you know, brought me comfort knowing that, you know, I wasn't alone and that there were other women that had gone through that and survived it and went on to, you know, have healthy pregnancies after. So I'll kind of go into detail more about that situation at a later time, but it ended up being one of those things that for me, even though the miscarriage was something that was heartbreaking for us, it was something that I was sort of able to rationalize in my head. And I think it was because I was 38. And I know that as you get older, you know, the risk of having, you know, pregnancy issues or high risk pregnancies just becomes, you know, a little bit more relevant. And I got through that situation, but what I had a really hard time with was sort of getting my body back after that and getting back in shape and trying to get healthy again so that we could try to conceive again, because I was getting closer to 40 and I knew that that point was a point where it was going to be even more difficult. So I jumped into a program at my local gym where they were advertising a group where you could lose 10 inches in 10 days. And so I, without hesitation, jumped in that situation, went through a nutrition plan and an exercise program where, in fact, after that 10 days, I was able to lose just about 10 inches. I think it was 9.75 inches or something in my body in 10 days, just by changing some nutritional habits that I had and incorporating a specific workout program. So now today, I always say I'm always 10 days away from whatever body I want, because I've kind of gone through that and I know what it takes to get that done. So I was going into this thing sort of wanting to fix my body, because my doctor was very urgent for me to get pregnant, because I was now 39 years old and I was starting to stress out about being pregnant at 40. And he kept suggesting, you know, fertility treatments and, you know, just going some of those, you know, infertility routes with us, because it had been a year and I wasn't able to conceive and I was having a bunch of, you know, woman issues, and he thought that that would be the best way to go. And because I wasn't able to get pregnant, he wanted me to go have some exploratory surgery to see if maybe there was some fallopian tube problems and all that kind of stuff. So I got through my 10-day challenge. I got in really great shape. We kind of had a mental and emotional cutoff of December to see if I wasn't pregnant by December, we were kind of just going to call it quits and we were going to go through an adoption process. And lo and behold, that December, a week before I was supposed to go into exploratory surgery, I found out I was pregnant. And so I used nutrition and fitness and some lifestyle changes to correct whatever infertility issues I had and whatever issues I had going inside my body, and allowed myself to be in a position where I was able to conceive a child at 39. I used all those practices that I had learned in that challenge and was able to have a very healthy pregnancy at 40. My doctor swore I was going to have gestational diabetes, so I put myself on a diabetic diet and was able to avoid any of those sort of issues at a 40-year-old pregnancy. Had my daughter, she's healthy, pregnancy was great. I whipped right back into shape after the pregnancy because my daughter had some milk allergies, which again, our doctors or pediatricians said there was no such thing as a milk allergy. In fact, my daughter had a milk allergy, and so I wanted to breastfeed. I cut all dairy out of my diet while I was breastfeeding. She was healed, and I was able to lose weight really fast after my pregnancy, so it was a really good experience. But why I'm sharing this story with you is because the doctor's advice that I was given to fix what was going on with me was all based on textbook medical experience, and nothing really made sense for me and my personal body and my lifestyle. And what I chose to do instead of taking my doctor's advice in those situations was use kind of common sense and just clean up my body from the inside and exercise some proper nutrition, get my body back in shape, get my emotions back in shape after the miscarriage. And we were able to have that pregnancy. And we were able to also fix the issues that my daughter was having. She was having severe dairy allergies as an infant. We were able to reverse all of that through nutrition and just doing some experimentation and putting some common sense into practice. Now, let's move forward. Got through the pregnancy, got through the breastfeeding. My daughter still has allergies to milk these days. We're a dairy-free family, so that's not a problem. I start going through some perimenopausal issues. Go in to see a doctor, explain to him my symptoms. I walk out with 3 prescriptions. One was for depression, one was for water retention, which is basically a high blood pressure medication, and the other one was for a referral for some surgery that I didn't need. I took those prescriptions. I was sort of mad at the fact that I went in just to get some help and have someone kind of understand what I was going through. I felt like I was crazy when I walked out, and I had 3 prescriptions in my hand with my doctor's assistant telling me that I should just take the antidepressant, not tell anyone in my family that I was taking it, and see how they liked how I was acting, sort of thing, like a joke. Like, just see if my bitchiness went away if I was taking my antidepressant. So that sent me through the roof, and I was absolutely livid, and I never went back. My point again is, if you're feeling some things that aren't right with your body, I encourage you to do some research and use some common sense and try some experimentation and see if there's some things that you can do. In that situation with my perimenopausal symptoms, I took matters into my own hands. Again, I made some nutrition changes and I made some lifestyle changes, and I can confidently say that I am through perimenopause. I am into menopause, and I am happier and healthier than I've probably ever been. And I just made the decision to do things on my own and do some experimenting. If it was up to my doctor, I would probably have a counter full of prescriptions trying to cover up symptoms and not actually heal my body. And I chose to heal my body with using nutrition and food and, you know, like I said, common sense stuff, making sure my environment was healthy, making sure when I did have a bad day that that was just okay. We're allowed to have bad days. I didn't write it off to being hormonal or a woman or whatever, we can have bad days. We don't need to medicate ourselves because of that. We just get through it and we ask for some grace and some time and we move on to the next day. Now, I want to share with you guys a little conversation that I had with a woman that I'm working with in one of my intermittent fasting groups. So she went to her doctor just for a checkup, no real serious medical issues going on. She kind of mentioned to her doctor that she was going to start intermittent fasting, and she had some things going on in her life with some personal stuff with her family that was, you know, causing her some stress. And so her doctor suggested that she did not start intermittent fasting because it would put her body in a stressful situation. So she was concerned about that and called me to ask me for some advice. So I'm going to share with you guys the advice that I gave her today and kind of help you think through the process of when a doctor is giving you advice. And before you take that advice, of course, if it's a diehard medical situation, you always want to go on that side of caution. You want to trust your doctor if it's a life or death situation or it's a serious medical condition. And even those, you should do your research and get a second opinion. And I'm not a doctor or a nutritionist or a dietitian. I'm just a person who uses common sense and does a lot of research and is willing to apply some things and see if they work. So with that being said, when she said that to me, I was like, well, how does that even make sense? Intermittent fasting is just picking a time of the day that you choose not to eat and then picking a time of the day that you are going to eat. And if you're stressed out, don't we as women typically like err on the bad side of things? Don't we usually stress eat? Don't we usually unconsciously eat? Don't we usually eat bad things? Don't we usually, if we're busy and we're away from home, run through a drive-thru and fill ourselves full of fast food stuff or processed foods or quick fix foods? And how is that healthy? How is that a situation that if you're stressed out, you're going to be in a better position than if you put yourself in a position where you're consciously controlling how, when, and why you eat? And so when we started talking through this process and kind of common sensing our way into a solution, it was like crazy the advice that her doctor was giving to her, because there's no medical reason why she can't intermittent fast. Intermittent fasting is going to actually make the situation that she's currently going through so much less stressful. Because if you're going to be away from home and running around taking care of family members that need you because they're not doing so well, and your life's going to be full of stress and chaos, and you're going to eliminate the need to eat every 2 hours, and you're going to carve out a time that you're going to put nutrients in your body that are a really great choice for yourself, and you're going to be in total control of that situation, how can intermittent fasting be a bad thing? And when we broke it down, like that common sense and that realistic and that everyday, it only made sense that this is a perfect time for her to start intermittent fasting, because the alternative of stress eating and rush eating and quick fix eating through a drive-through when you have no time, can you imagine how you're going to feel when you get out of that situation? You're going to feel 10 times worse than whatever situation you're in now, right before you start to do something good for yourself. So I'm coming to you tonight to kind of share these little stories and these situations to give you some, I don't know, courage maybe, or some empowerment to really question when people are giving you advice. And when someone's giving you advice, take a moment to just pause and sort of lean into it and think about what the long-term effects of those decisions are going to be. And if the advice that you're getting is really personalized to you and the current situation that you're in, or is it just textbook advice that they would give to you and 10 other random people that came in behind you? Because it's really easy to write a prescription, and it's really fast to write a prescription, but it takes time and commitment and some compassion and a relationship for someone to offer you advice that's personalized to your situation and really hear what you're having to say that's going on with your body and listen to the needs that you have or the desires that you have to fix yourself. And so if you're in a situation where you're kind of concerned about some things that are going on, yes, you definitely want to go speak to your doctor or whoever it is that you go to for a medical advice, and then pause on it for a minute or two and do some research and think about what those consequences could be if you just blindly took their advice without taking into consideration the long-term effects for you. So if I would have taken my doctor's advice when I wanted to get pregnant. There was no guarantees that what we were going to enter into was going to be what we needed. It would have cost us a ton of money to go the infertility route to have a baby. The reality is we didn't really need it. Something was just off chemically with my body, and food fixed it. Food was also the problem, which is probably why I was having a problem conceiving a child at 38 or 39. And when I put clean nutrients into my body and thought about what it was I was doing with my nutrition and thought about what I was doing to care for my body and my mind and my soul and my broken heart from the miscarriage, I was fine. I was able to fix myself. And when I was nursing my daughter and she was sick all the time because I was consuming all these foods that were every day that all had milk in them, and she had a very serious dairy allergy, and it was not recognized in the medical community, but it was seriously being recognized by my daughter. And my son also had the same issues, which caused me to stop nursing him at 6 months, when if I would have just known he had a milk allergy, I could have changed my diet and I could have nursed him longer. But in that situation, I wasn't experienced enough, or wasn't, I guess, maybe confident enough to question my doctor. And with my daughter, I was. And so I was able to nurse her for 14 months and she had no issues whatsoever. And we know now that dairy is just that thing that her and my son and I cannot consume. Move on to my perimenopause days. The same thing. If I would have blindly listened to my doctor, I would have been on hormone replacement. I would have been on a high blood pressure medication to control my water retention, which was actually a gluten and soy sensitivity. And since I've taken gluten and soy out of my body, I no longer retain water, no blood pressure medication needed. My hormones are totally in balance since I've made some dietary changes and started intermittent fasting. No hormone replacement is needed. My thyroid has totally been repaired, so I don't need to take thyroid medicine. My autoimmune disorder has been cured. I no longer need to have any kind of medication or medical treatment for that. And I'm fine and I'm healthy and I'm 50 years old. I didn't have to take any of those medications, and I'm also not on antidepressants, and I've never been depressed, and I'm totally happy. So question things, do some research, try experimenting with things, and know that food, if you're not careful and if you're not aware of what it is you're putting in your body, can and will at some point in your life make you sick. We don't know what the food's going to be. We don't know what time of your life it's going to happen, but it's happening to everyone. I mean, it seems like every woman I talk to has some sort of rare autoimmune disorder that just popped up, or a thyroid that's gone astray, or hormone imbalance, or sudden weight gain. And all of those things, I'm telling you guys, can be fixed if you just listen to your body and do some experimenting. Don't get yourself in that position where you're going to be stuck on medications that you won't be able to get off of, or stuck on medications that you take medication A and now you got to take medication B and C to offset the symptoms that medication A started. And we don't need to be those women. We don't need to be those people that are going to be stuck to pharmaceutical medications if we try food first and food can fix us. Again, like I always say, if it is one of those things that has to be controlled by medication, then you definitely want to go that route. But I urge you to do some checking first. I hope this is helpful for you guys. And I hope you know that if you are suffering from something, you're definitely not alone. I have been battling with my hormones for probably the last 12 years. And I can say that I've won the battle. I've done a lot of experimenting. I've done a lot of research. I've read a lot of books. I've talked to a lot of people. I've had a lot of bad days, but now I'm having more good days. And you deserve to have the same thing. So pay attention to your body, listen to what's going on, go seek some medical advice, and then weigh the advice that you get from the medical industry with some research and advice you can get from the holistic energy community, and see if you can merge those two together and find a happy place for you. I am always an open book, and I'm always available if you have any questions or need some advice. Definitely feel free to reach out to me. I always keep anything that you share with me private. And I have, like I said, I have no problem sharing some of the things that I've gone through. And if I can't get you the help that you need or the answer that you need, I will always do my best to point you in the right direction to get some help for yourself. Thank you so much for joining me tonight. If you are catching this on a replay or a rebroadcast, feel free to leave a comment below. Or as I just said, if you need to reach out to me, that invitation goes to you as well. Never be afraid to seek help. Talk amongst your girlfriends. I promise you, you are not the only one going through this. All women are suffering something. And if you seek the advice of your girlfriends, you'll find that you'll probably have a tribe and a nice community of people who are going to go through the same thing that you are and can offer you some support as well. So thanks so much for joining me. I will catch you guys probably on Sunday or Monday. Tomorrow's Friday, so I'm taking tomorrow night off. And then it's date night on Saturday, so I'll be taking Saturday night off too. And I'll catch you guys Sunday or Monday. Have a good night, you guys.